Hi, my name is Patrick, scored 100 percentile 6 times in CAT. This specific video is basically how to prepare for CAT DILA section for a 2-hour paper. Now in a 2-hour paper where the time was reduced from 3 hours to 2 hours, DILA become the most challenging part of the paper. Because each set of DILA takes a long time and by chance, if there's a problem, it is a little difficult to recover in a 40 minutes paper. In a 1-hour paper, 1-hour DILA section, you can still recover. But 40 minutes, I'm not saying it's not possible. If you're relaxed, I'm sure you can recover from even a bad start. Okay, let's look at difference first. Again, same thing, you have almost 1.88 minutes per question in a 3-hour paper, 32 questions, 60 minutes. But in a 2-hour paper, you have 1.67 minutes per question, 24 questions, 40 minutes. 13% more faster you'll have to solve if you want to solve all questions. Technically, no one solves all the questions, okay, rarely. But still, what it means is you have more number of questions which are there. What are the challenges that could be faced in DILA section? The biggest challenge is the 2-hour paper, the 40 minutes part. I mean, the fact that it's a 40 minutes paper, I mean, if you by any chance have a problem in the paper, like wrong question selection or taking a longer time for a question, you may come under tremendous stress because there may not be too much time to recover. Yes, for people who are relaxed, they can normally do well, okay, because they can recover. But if you're not relaxed, then it could be an issue. So if a single set takes extra time, it may create stress. So normally what happens, even if you take 15-20 minutes for one set in a 1-hour paper, you still have a lot of time to cover up for the other sets. But here, if you take 15-20 minutes for one set and you don't get the answer, half your time is gone and you've not even got a single set. So that is the issue. Difficult to recover from a wrong set selection. So if you by chance select a set wrong, you start solving it, you waste your time, and then becomes a little difficult. One, because you feel that time is ticking, so you're under stress, and yes, your time is a little bit less, that doesn't work. But normally what I've seen is your person who's relaxed can easily come back. I mean, normally one set you can solve it within 10 minutes. So even if you have a bad start, you can come back and solve 2 or 3 sets and still get a very good percentile. Number of questions to get a good percentile is less. So that could be advantage. So if I'm relaxed, I can solve a couple of sets. I think that should help to get good percentile. Also, there's one more challenge to decide between 4 questions and 6 question sets. Should I go for 6 question set, which could be slightly tougher and take maybe more time, but there are more questions. So automatically one set, I'll get 6 questions right. Or should I go for 4 question set, which could be easier, but there are only 4 questions. So all that you will have to plan in your whole paper. When you plan your paper, that's one consideration you have to give. Preparation. Focus on the ability to decide the toughness of a mock. That means you should be able to decide in a short span of time whether a mock or a set is tough or easy. A lot of people don't focus on this. They focus on solving the questions. Solving is important, but when the time is less, you should be able to decide the toughness of a question or a set in a short period of time. Work on the parameters to select set. Look at which parameters are important, which parameters are not important. For example, maybe if there are too many variables, you find it difficult to solve. Or maybe if there are too much data, you find it difficult to solve. Or maybe if there's too much of calculations, you find it difficult to solve. See what works for you, what doesn't work for you. Which type of questions you prefer and which type you don't. So over a period of time, as and when you practice more and more sets, you should be comfortable with it. Know when to leave a set, very important. I mean, you cannot start a set and keep on solving it, because then you may waste a lot of time and not even get the answer. So know when to leave a set. Learn to solve sets quickly. So start a set, again, you can't waste a lot of time. So there are two different things. First thing is, if you don't get to solve, if you don't get the answer, you should know when to leave a set. And you can't waste a lot of time leaving a set. And apart from that, you should also reduce the time in whatever sets you are solving, because as the time is less, you need to try to solve faster. Paper strategy could be first focus on selection of sets. That means one strategy should be go to all the sets. There will be 5 sets, right? So you can go to all the sets before you select easy sets. Second strategy should be at least go to 2 or 3 sets before you start solving. Avoid solving the first set that comes. Okay, it makes sense to pick up an easier set and then try to solve. Hope that helps. Thank you.